Hughes's presentation of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is presented by Jack in the Box and Doritos.
Welcome back to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame induction ceremony. Guys, make sure you go to www.fuse.tv/rockhall for live blogging. But right now, let's go back to the main stage where Jeff Beck is about to be inducted.
I have done other music after the Yardbirds, but anyway, somebody told me I should be proud tonight. But I'm not, because they kicked me out. They did. Damn.
The story of the first Jeff Beck group was, what do you go after the Yardbirds? I couldn't just sit around and do nothing. And the first problem was having a lead singer. Oh, God, I hate lead singers.
Over here. Help me love you, baby. You're driving my poor heart crazy.
Rod Stewart, he looked ridiculous. He had a bullhorn hairstyle, teased up him. Not, it wasn't spiky, it was just all flat, like a kind of a hat. And I thought, well, he's so good, who cares what he looks like, you know? You know, I ain't no oil painting anyways.
This is completely solid.
Yeah, absolutely. These pickups are very powerful.
The strings seem very light. Is this to facilitate the bending?
Partly the reason is I've got very weak flesh on my fingers.
Yeah.
And the bending that I do, it would probably slice it up like a piece of cheese.
Don't touch it.
I wasn't going to touch it.
No, don't touch it.
I was just pointing at it.
Well, don't point, even.
Don't even point?
No, it can't be played. Never. I mean,
can I look at it?
No.
Take no notice, I don't practice every day now. But I should practice more often because I've not even got a quarter of the way where I want to go.
to induct Jeff Beck into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, ladies and gentlemen, Jimmy Page.
Thank you. Yeah, thanks, Cleveland, for such a wonderful welcome. I've got to say, you've just seen that wonderful footage up there of a very dear friend of mine, Jeff. And, you know, Jeff and I, we go back to really early teens. And let me tell you, that was a long while ago. but we must have been about 13, 14 when we first met. And, you know, we stayed friends all the way through. And I did session work, and Jeff was in bands, and then Jeff was in the Yardbirds, and then I was in the Yardbirds with Jeff. And, well, you know, we went on after Jeff started making solo records, and I carried on with the Yardbirds for a while. And we both started to continue in our own sort of way. I sort of had Led Zeppelin, and Jeff kept going, and I got to tell you, I got to tell you that you'd sort of listen to Jeff along the way, and you'd go, "Wow, he's getting really, really good, Jeff," you know. And you'd hear him a few years later, and he'd just keep getting better and better and better, and he still has all the way through. And he leaves us mere mortals, believe me, you know, just wondering and having so much respect for him, because Jeff's whole guitar style has. It's just totally unorthodox to the way that anyone was taught. And he's just really developed a whole style that of expanding the electric guitar and making it into something which was just sounds and techniques totally unheard of before. And that's just an amazing feat, believe me. As you know, he's done some amazing fusion records. Blow by Blow, for a start, was just a solo record that you know, just established him as just the most incredible soloist of our time, you know. And he just doesn't stop. He gets better and better and better. And I tell you, I'm really honored to be here to induct Jeff into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, because he's done so much for rock and roll, and he always will. Come on, Jeff.
Jim, thank you so much for that. I've been naughty all my life, and I don't deserve this at all. But I shall continue to be naughty, I think. But, what's that? Sorry, I've lost a bit of hearing. It's all Pete Townsend's fault. But I really don't deserve this. I've been so naughty all my life. But people have been behind me, you know. I got to mention Ernest Chapman, who looked after my finances, and boy, did he look after them for 30 years. And he steered me through minefields of financial trouble. And he knew nothing about rock and roll, but he had a kind of Colonel Tom Parker quality about him. He sort of knew that if he hung around me long enough, I might do something worthwhile. And he's no longer my manager, because I think he prefers golf. So. We'll let him do that. And I'm very proud that Harvey Goldsmith is now my manager. And here he is right here, Harvey. And big hand for Harvey Goldsmith. Last of all, I mean, there's so many people that have helped me. And I'd like to extend a huge thanks to them. And a huge thanks to those that didn't, you know, help me out. So. Thank you, Jim. And to stand here in front of Scotty is just more than I ever could believe, you know, and DJ and all that. But you guys, I mean, Jimmy, you'll back me up on this. You know, we used to sit and just, you know, dribble over your playing, you know, fantastic. Thank you for that. Thank you all. Thank you. That's it. And my wife, my dear wife, Sandra.
Fuse's presentation of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is presented by Jack in the Box and Doritos. Fuse's presentation of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is presented by Jack in the Box and Doritos.
Ladies and gentlemen, backstage with the legend, Mr. Jimmy Page, who just inducted Jeff Beck in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. How long have you known Jeff Beck?
I've literally known Jeff since I was about 13. I lived in Epsom and he lived in Wallingford, which is very close to each other, actually, two towns in Surrey in England. And I was playing guitar and it sort of got to be known in the area and the local art college. Somebody that I was acquainted with, who was a record collector, knew Jeff's sister. Okay. And he was older than I was and she was older than Jeff. But they said, you know, maybe you should get these two guys together. So we actually met up with homemade guitars and we showed each other our homemade guitars. We also had regular guitars as well.
That's absolutely
so
amazing.
So yeah, it goes back to when we're about 13, but it's this whole thing, and what we're here for now, it's all about kids in, you know, in their house with their parents' house playing guitars and checking licks, and same deal for everyone, really.
It's just so amazing that, you know, he's in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, you're in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. What do you have to say to bands coming up, how to achieve such longevity and maybe someday get in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
Oh, well, just stick to what you believe in. Because if you believe in it, you're probably not compromising, which means that you'll change the passage of music by doing that.
Oh,
sure.
Absolutely amazing.
Yeah, just stay true to yourself. Believe, you know.
Jimmy Page, this is
all
awesome.
Right.
Thank you so much. We're gonna go back to Jared now. Hey, Jared, I'm with your favorite, Jimmy Page.
How cool is it that my boy Steven just interviewed the legend Jimmy Page? Yeah. The Led Zeppelin legend. Amazing. But right now, he's going back up on stage to perform with Jeff Beck. Let's check it out.
A big chunk of Led Zeppelin right here. Jimmy Page! We'll be right back.
Reprise's presentation of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is presented. This presentation of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is presented by Jack in the Box and Doritos.
Okay, we are backstage here at the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame with Rock and Roll Hall of Famer Jeff Beck, who's been inducted before, but how does it feel being inducted as a solo artist?
It's a whole different thing. You know, I was great. It's always a good buzz coming to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame anyway, whether you're within a band or solo. But I think, you know, to know that so many years after that induction that somebody's still listening to me, you know, as a solo player, and obviously it's no comparison when you get, you know, voted in as a solo player instead of being within a band. It's right. So much more ego boosting, I guess, you know.
Do you think there aren't enough just straight up guitar players in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
Probably not. I mean, there's quite a few guitars there, though. I mean, there's like a warehouse of guitars, you know. You know, but
What do you say to a kid who's starting to play guitar right now to achieve what you've achieved?
Good luck. It's a bit late in the day, I guess, unless you've got, you're made of the right stuff. You know, what else can you do with a guitar? But there you go, and you know, somebody's going to invent something, and I just hope they do, you know, because it's like people like Eric that have kept it going, you know, with his finely crafted songs, not just the playing being amazing, but the songs keep it alive. And we need another Eric that does both, you know, so well.
I'm just thrilled that we have a Jeff Beck.
How? Thanks. Well, I don't sing, but I try to sing through the guitar, and that's really what I try to do.
Yeah, that what you did with the Peter Gunn theme was mind-blowing. Face-melting, they say. Jeff Beck, thank you so much for talking to us. Congratulations on being a Rock and Roll Hall of Famer. We got lots more Rock and Roll Hall of Fame action.
Attention up.
This presentation of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is presented by Jack in the Box and Doritos.
It has been a great night for music. We've seen some incredible performances,
amazing,
some moving speeches, and don't forget to go to fuse.tv/rockhall for some more live blogging.
Oh, but the night is not over yet. We're going to say goodnight, and you guys are going to go watch what the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame induction ceremony is all about, the finale jams. Yeah. You do not want to miss this, so let's go to the stage right now. Dude, let's go.
Let's go. Come on, let's get out of here.
This is rhythm guitar player heaven, all right? I don't have to compete with this. I just do this. She won't.
sure that a saying goes around me, for I used to love
the door, bringing it in.